Welcome back to Go Gaddis Real Estate Radio right here on AM 920 The Answer. In this segment, what is the shopping cart theory and what does it say about you and your fellow neighbors and just human beings in general? And how do you avoid being scammed by fake online listings? My name is Cleve Gaddis. That's short for Cleveland Gaddis. You're listening to Go Gaddis Real Estate Radio. Our goal here is very simple, to help listeners go from real estate novices to experts so home selling and buying can be done with total confidence and without all the worry typical with life's biggest investments. I cannot tell you, I am a full-time real estate professional. I am a broker and a team leader. I've been in real estate for 22 years. Me and my business partner, Christy Valley, own Modern Traditions Realty Group. And I cannot tell you how many times I see a consumer, a buyer or a seller on the opposite side of a transaction from us who is simply not fully educated on what the forms they sign mean or what the inspections they should or shouldn't do are. There's just so many opportunities for people to go into a real estate transaction with their eyes closed. And I don't mean they would do that on purpose with their eyes closed, but they go in with their eyes closed. And it's a shame because you as an adult deserve to know everything you need to know before you make some of the most, if not the most important financial decision of your life. Don't forget, we want to connect, and it is easy to connect with us. Simply go to gogaddisradio.com. That's GOGADDIS radio.com. You can ask questions. You can make comments. You can push back or challenge things we say. You can share your ideas with us, and we love it when you do. You can request we feature your neighborhood in our neighborhood spotlight to help you and your neighbors understand what's happening in your market. Do you have an advantage when it comes to selling your home? And you can also subscribe to our podcast. We're available on every major podcasting platform. I don't know about you, but when I go to the store, the grocery store, to Target, anything, any store where they have carts, one thing I can tell you is that I am never, ever guilty of leaving them in the store parking lot. I will always put them back in their designated spot. I'm not saying that makes me better than anyone else, but there is a theory called the shopping cart theory. It gained attention a few years back and then again recently on social media. And if you're wondering exactly what it is, let me tell you a little bit about it. The shopping cart is the ultimate litmus test, the shopping cart theory says, for whether a person is capable of self-governing. That's a big statement. To return the shopping cart is an easy and convenient task, one which we all recognize as the correct, appropriate thing to do. To return the shopping cart is objectively right. There are no situations other than dire emergencies in which a person is not able to return their cart, or if they simply are physically not able to return their cart. Simultaneously, it is not illegal to abandon your shopping cart. Therefore, the shopping cart presents itself as the apex example of whether a person will do what is right without being forced to do it. The shopping cart is what determines whether or not this article says a person is, now listen to this, a good or bad member of society. Man, I don't want to be called a bad member of society under any circumstances. Here's sort of a summary. The shopping cart, when you go grocery shopping, you use a shopping cart to carry items around the store, unless you're with my girlfriend Tammy, and if we don't have enough items to fill up a shopping cart, we get a little basket. She almost always insists. Whether or not you return the cart is important. After you finish shopping and loaded your groceries into your car, you have a choice. Return the shopping cart to the designated cart return area or leave it in the parking lot. You have choices and responsibility. Returning the cart is not required by store rules in most places, nor is it typically enforced by law. It's a choice left to individuals. It has ethical implications. Proponents of the shopping cart theory argue that returning the cart is a simple task that demonstrates consideration for others and a willingness to contribute to the common good. It's seen as a measure of a person's character, whether they choose to do something helpful, even when it's not strictly required of them. And they say there is sort of a social contract. Some see returning the cart as a metaphor for fulfilling social responsibilities that benefit everyone, even when there's no immediate personal gain or consequence for failing to do so. The theory suggests the ultimate way to test moral goodness is to see whether or not someone will do the right thing in the absence of accountability, consequence, or reward. I don't know if you agree with the shopping cart theory. I think it's kind of a broad, overreaching statement to say people who do not put their shopping carts up are not good members of society, because in some cases, maybe that's not that what they were taught to do or something they've never thought of. But I'd love to hear what you have to think. Go to Go Gaddis Radio, G-O-G-A-D-D-I-S Radio. Click on Contact Us. Tell me what you think about the shopping cart theory. Do you agree? Let's change to a new subject, and that is online scams. Man, they are everywhere. So much of our day-to-day activities are done online, and this, as you probably are already well aware, increases the opportunity for someone to commit fraud and for us to fall for it. There are ways to protect yourself and your family. We received a listener question from Mario and Marietta. It says, how can we protect our identity? Got a couple of tips here real quickly, you know, and as more day-to-day activities continue to go online, again, that opportunity for fraud, as I mentioned a minute ago, continues to increase, especially within social media sale groups. While these platforms offer a convenient way to buy and sell items, they also harbor risks that are similar to those found in traditional classified ads and in marketplaces. Interbank has put together a set of guidelines to help you when buying or selling on social media marketplaces. Before you dive in, one of the first lines of defenses against any online scams is securing your own account. Fraudsters commonly seize legitimate accounts to add credibility to their scams, activating two-factor authentication, man, I messed that one up big time, is a crucial step that adds an extra layer of security, requiring a verification code from a device that only you control, effectively keeping scammers at bay. Here's some warning signs. Scammers are becoming increasingly sophisticated, exploiting the convenience and reach of social media platforms to deceive unsuspecting buyers. Here are some key warning signs. Number one, unbelievably low prices. Number two, avoidance of in-person meetings. General sellers usually welcome or suggest meeting in person. Number three, a request for payment in gift cards. No legitimate transaction should require payment via gift card. Number four, communication evasion. Sellers who refuse to directly communicate or try to redirect you to external sites, you should be aware of them. Suspicious email addresses. Research the seller's email to check for a history of associated scams. I would assume you could just type it into Google and say, is blankety-blank at gmail.com a scam? And if it's been reported, maybe Google will tell you. When you have multiple listings for the same item, that should be a red flag. And overly creative excuses for bargain prices. I'm going to do this because my late husband passed away. And by the way, there are probably some situations around the world where people are in difficult situations and they do need some help, and it is legitimate. But when somebody says, I've inherited a bunch of money and I need to send you, I want to give it all to you, and all you need to do is send me some money first, you need to be careful. My mother is 84 years old, be 85 in November, and I am amazed at the amount of scam emails she receives, even on her company email address. And I have insisted that she just send those to me and say, hey, is this real or is this a scam? And I will tell you, 90% of the time, they're scams. Additional scam tactics to watch out for: fake payments and refund requests. Be wary of buyers insisting on using mobile payment apps, and a check over payment scam. Never accept checks for more than the purchase price. This is a big one. When selling online, it is best to deal with local buyers you can meet in person, accepting only cash to avoid most scams. If dealing with non-local buyers, familiarize yourself with the seller protections offered by the platform. Getting back to Mario's questions, Mario's, how do I protect my identity? And the reality is, you just need to be very careful. And if something seems like a scam, sounds like a scam, could be a scam, it probably is a scam. And you always want to be careful giving your information to people online. This segment of the show is brought to you by the law firm of O'Kelly and Sorahan. They have 30 offices throughout Metro Atlanta, and they are our preferred closing attorney. They are the only closing attorney that I ever like to close at personally. Why? Because their customer service is so much better. If you want to reach them, it is easy. Dial 770-497-0000. Excuse me. 770-497-1880. I gave you my phone number. My phone number is 770-497-0000. O'Kelly and Sorahan is very close. 770-497-1880. Or go to gogaddisradio.com and ask us to connect you. If you're listening or you know someone who is, if you're listening and you're thinking of doing this, or you know someone who is thinking about selling their home, in the next 6 to 12 months, we believe we can get you $28,000 more in your pocket than other real estate brokerages, agents, and teams can. If that sounds too good to be true, go to gogaddisradio.com, G-O-G-A-D-D-I-S-radio.com. Click on $28,000 more. Put in just a little bit of information. We'll reach out to you. Two things we'll do that we don't believe anyone else will do. Number one, we determine the value of your home using what's called a maximum value plan. As far as I know, we're the only ones in the state of Georgia that actually compute values this way, and it is designed to help us find value that others might miss. And you get up to $15,000 to use to improve the condition of your home. Go to gogaddisradio.com, click on $28,000 more, put in a little information, we'll follow up with you right away. In our neighborhood spotlight, we're featuring North Fork Plantation in Grayson. And what happens in the housing market during an election year? And what if you have doggy doo-doo being left in your yard by someone other than, or by a dog other than your dog? Stick with us. We've got those subjects and more. We'll be back.